Hi astronomers, Caroline here. Imagine traveling to the moon, to Mars, or even far beyond the reaches of our solar system. You might be picturing some kind of spaceship, but do you think you'd need the same kind of spaceship to explore each of these different places? We're going to find out. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain how different types of spacecraft are used in space exploration. Let's get started. We can divide the spacecraft astronomers use to explore our universe into two main categories: crewed and uncrewed. Let's take a look at uncrewed spacecraft first. An uncrewed spacecraft is designed to operate without a human crew inside. Instead, the spacecraft is controlled from Earth. What do you think are some pros and cons of using uncrewed spacecraft to explore the universe? Consider what we already know about the expanse of space, then pause the video here and record your predictions in your guided notes. Remember, space is really, truly, indescribably huge. NASA estimates that to travel just to the closest planet to us, Mars, it would take about 7 months there and 7 months back. Can you imagine how difficult it would be to pack over a year's worth of food and water for astronauts on a mission to Mars? Whew. Luckily, uncrewed spacecraft don't get hungry, or thirsty, or just bored. Plus, humans are pretty particular about the conditions we live in. We need oxygen to breathe and to be at a nice, comfortable temperature. Uncrewed spacecraft don't have this problem either. They can brave even the harshest conditions in space. In fact, there's an uncrewed spacecraft currently orbiting the upper atmosphere of the sun. I don't think there's an air conditioner powerful enough to convince a human to take that ride. But, on the other hand, uncrewed spacecraft are totally on their own once they get launched into space. That means they aren't very flexible. They just have the tools they were launched with. And if any of those tools break, well, that can be the end of the mission. So, uncrewed probes aren't perfect, but they can explore distant reaches of space that humans simply can't yet. That's why scientists have created a few different kinds of uncrewed spacecraft to help them explore our universe. The first is one you might already be familiar with: satellites. These uncrewed spacecraft orbit around a celestial body. We've sent satellites to orbit the sun, the moon, and most of the other planets in our solar system. These satellites carry telescopes and other scientific equipment that we can use to study space. Since satellites stay in their orbits, they can help us gather consistent information from the same place over time. But when astronomers need a more on-the-go option, they use probes. These are uncrewed spacecraft designed to travel through the depths of space and send back information they gather. But what about when we want to take a closer look at a celestial body instead of just flying past or orbiting it? That's where rovers come in. A rover is an uncrewed spacecraft designed to move around on the surface of a celestial body. They're basically a remote-controlled laboratory on wheels. Rovers help us explore the surface of distant worlds and gather all sorts of information that we can't figure out from probes and satellites alone. But there are still other times that we want a more hands-on approach to space exploration, and that's where crewed spacecraft come in. Crewed spacecraft are operated by a human crew on board. What do you think the pros and cons of these kinds of spacecraft might be? Pause the video here while you record your thoughts in your guided notes. The crews on these spacecraft are typically highly trained astronomers, engineers, and other kinds of scientists. Their problem-solving and creativity often helps them learn things from a mission that an uncrewed spacecraft couldn't. Plus, humans can carry out more complex tasks. For example, it's hard to program a robotic arm to gather samples of moon rocks or to fix a satellite. But a human crew can do this stuff pretty easily. But while humans are resourceful and flexible, we're also pretty particular about things like having air to breathe and food to eat, which, as you can imagine, isn't so simple in space. Creating spacecraft that can safely transport a crew and return to Earth afterwards is much more difficult than creating a satellite or a rover. But despite these challenges, many scientists and space enthusiasts believe that crewed missions are an essential part of our efforts to explore the universe. So, let's take a look at the kinds of crewed spacecraft. The one you're probably most familiar with is called a space shuttle. These crewed spacecraft were launched by rockets, then glided back to Earth's surface. They've been phased out of service now and replaced with more modern spacecraft, but they were really important to our efforts to explore space for many years. The space shuttles were designed only to travel within a few hundred miles of the Earth's surface. During the missions where astronauts landed on the moon, they used a different kind of spacecraft called a lander. A lander is designed to carefully, gently touch down on the surface of a celestial body. Then the crew inside can gather information about the place they landed. So, if the space shuttles weren't designed to go to the moon, what did they do in orbit around Earth? Well, the space shuttles were designed to carry both a crew and large amounts of cargo. Crews on space shuttles helped launch probes, repair satellites, and even build another kind of crewed spacecraft, space stations. Space stations are basically complete labs and observatories that orbit the Earth in space. They have electricity, water, food, air, everything a crew needs to live in space for a long time while they study space. There are astronauts living and learning on two space stations in orbit right now, and there are plans to keep crews working in them for years to come. From satellites and probes to space shuttles and stations, we've invented some pretty incredible ways of exploring space already, and we're always innovating new technologies that can help us explore even farther. Let's review what we learned about them today. Now you know that there are many kinds of both crewed and uncrewed spacecraft, and that each type of spacecraft has advantages and disadvantages that make them well-suited to different kinds of missions. And each different kind has helped us learn incredible things about our universe. You can check out the practice questions and extension activities that go with this lesson to learn more about the ways we explore the universe. And always remember, you are out of this world. See you next time!